There's birds in the background?
Almost like my eyes got an upgrade. Let's go, bro.
Look at the car. 240 hertz eyes.
This is actually crazy, bro.
Welcome to Rock Esports Center here in beautiful Miami, Florida. Today, we are testing the new Corsair Xeneon 27 QHD 240 hertz monitor. To answer this question, can you have a monitor that both visually blows your mind, but also has the high refresh rate you need to conquer the world of competitive shooters and esports? See, Corsair seems to think so. I have invited two top-tier Fortnite players to see if this is true. With the power and sponsorship of AMD's high-end gaming systems, we have set up a series of tests to answer that question, which is going to ultimately culminate in a series of food challenges that you are not gonna wanna miss. This is a 27-inch, 240 hertz, 1440p OLED display powered by LG's best OLED display technology. See, a sub-30-inch OLED display has been a myth up until this point, because most OLED displays are either large TVs or large monitors like the Corsair Xeneon Flex. Either that or like the small phones you carry in your pocket, and both of them with the highest refresh rate of about 120 hertz. This size and lack of high refresh rate has made it a no-go for competitive gaming. But Corsair is trying to change that by marrying organic light emitting diode, or OLED, which is known for its like infinite blacks and super rich colors, and couple that with 240 hertz and 0.03 millisecond response time to turn the head of competitive gamers. See, their world has been dominated by TN, VA, and IPS type displays that mute colors and lack that infinite contrast ratio. It's a world that's in desperate need of a change, if Corsair can pull it off. So I needed experts who can tell us if Corsair, with their partner LG Display, had actually accomplished what they had claimed to achieve. Let's meet the players. This professional esport player is not only a bilingual content creator, but a commentator and analyst as well. Amassing over 1 million plus followers globally and 70 plus million views, he has become a mainstay in the Fortnite community. And this player has quickly become one of the largest Fortnite creators in the world, most notably in zero build game mode. Amassing over 3.5 million plus followers, he has consistently been one of the most viewed Fortnite streamers month over month. Welcome, Zemie and Tocata.
So we're here for monitors, and monitors are important because today we're gonna debut a brand new product from Corsair that actually melds high refresh rate and OLED. And the big thing is that a lot of people don't understand how important monitors really are. So, Zemie, when you went and chose your first monitor, or when you choose a monitor, what's that process like? What goes through your head?
Yeah, so like you said, a monitor is very important when it comes to your setup. And I was the first on a 60 hertz monitor, then I upgraded to 144 and I saw a massive difference. And then everyone was telling me to upgrade to 240 and I was like, it can't be that big of a deal. And when I did, it was also a huge difference. So I think when it comes to my monitor, at least when I was choosing mine, refresh rate, also the response time, which is 1 millisecond, which is massive.
Okay, so you did notice, like, as you jumped up, your game got better.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah. Okay, that's a kind of for you. It's like, were there features? Like, what is it like? Like, you have done tournaments, you have grown. So what are kind of some of the features and things that you look at when you look for new monitors?
Yeah, so there's two key components I look for. It's a high refresh rate and a low millisecond response time, ideally 240 hertz refresh rate and 1 millisecond response time or less. So this is the reason one of the most asked questions in my community is, you know, I have a bit of money, what should I spend it on? A new keyboard, a new mouse? And the first thing I say is, you know, get a good rig, make sure your computer can run the games you want to play. But then priority number two, instantly after that, is get a high refresh rate monitor. It's going to be what improves your gameplay the most out of anything else you can get.
So we are doing our own event here today. We're going to kick it off with the first test. So what we have over here is we have a 27-inch, 240 hertz, one of the highest rated esport monitors on the market. So what you guys are gonna do is you're gonna play some duos. Then we're gonna do is we're gonna replace that monitor with a brand new Corsair 27-inch OLED. Same thing, play another game of duos. Let's see how the two monitors compare and if there was any impact to your game whatsoever. And to power those, because you talked about it, you have to have a system. We have these brand new AMD Advantage systems with 7950X3Ds and 7900XTXs.
To learn more about AMD Advantage systems, check out the video link down below. Gentlemen, go.
Let's do it.
Cue us up.
It's time.
Tocata.
It's game time. Let's go.
500 FPS right now. This is crazy.
Ooh, yeah, 400, 500. That's wild. You're gonna shot from behind?
Where's the other one?
On me?
20? Nice. I'm gonna try to get close. There's three left. We gotta kill everyone.
We gotta get everybody, literally half. All right, I got one.
Nice. He's somewhere on me, I think.
Now the question is,
where's his buddy?
Oh, there he is. Somewhere on me, I think he's in a full build fight.
There we go.
Let's go, bro.
Not bad. Okay, now we're gonna go grab the Corsair Xeneon 27 QHD 240Hz monitor and see how that goes.
Let's go, bro.
It's actually on epic settings right now.
Dude, it looks like Unreal settings. It's crazy.
What the performance?
Look at the background.
There's birds in the background. Do you see that? There's like they have colorful wings and everything.
This is actually crazy, bro.
Move around. I'm just moving the text at the top, like through Battle Pass item shop, like with my mouse.
I think the main thing for me is like the color. Like they're just so popping, you know? It's almost like my eyes got an upgrade.
I don't want to lose that streak, Zemie. I want to go 2 for 2.
Bro, we're literally going for 2 for 2 right now.
Okay. We're back at
it. Oh my god, beautiful drop.
This god drop.
Beautiful drop.
This is such a big god drop.
Dude, it's nice, bro. I know.
It's actually so smooth.
Dude, this is actually wild. I feel like now is when I'm really feeling the 0.03 millisecond.
There's people here.
Look at the car.
Look at that.
Yo, it's blinking at me.
I didn't know they updated the cars. Look at the glass and everything. I can see the red tint a lot
The
more.
Car has lights. It didn't before, I swear.
Wait, there's like a little bit of nitro going out the back of it. You see that?
That's what I'm saying, the light.
The light. He's one shot.
Dead?
Nice shot, bro.
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
That's a good hit.
The orange is orange. I don't know how to explain this. It's amazing.
If we play worse, it's because we're distracted by the environment. I'm frying
2040,
one right
now.
195.
Oh, 150, 150, right under you.
Oh, in front of me.
Oh, right here.
He's cracked.
Nice.
Good job.
Back to back.
That was great.
So I know that obviously starting off with two back-to-back victory royales, both in build and no build, and so you've gotten to use that super high-rated 240Hz monitor before. Now you've used the Corsair Xeneon. You have a lot of experience with a bunch of monitors. What did you guys think? Zemie, you first.
So when I turned on the monitor, the first thing I noticed was just how vibrant it is and like the colors. And when we loaded into the game, I remember you mentioned beforehand that it's 0.03 second. And when I got in the game, I immediately noticed that. I was like, there's something, this is 240Hz, but it feels better than 240Hz. So I think those are the two things that really, you know, popped off to me was the colors and the response time.
Tocata, thoughts? You've used your monitor before, you've used the other one. What do you think of the monitor?
Right, so the initial reaction was the same as Zemie's. I was like, oh, this is vibrant. It looked like they changed it to like in real life quality settings. But my main concern going in was normally we'll be playing on performance and kind of low quality modes because we want to separate the players from the environment we're playing in so it's easy to see them and obviously hit your shots. But I thought I'd kind of have an issue with this monitor, seeing the vibrance and the quality of it, but I did not have that issue at all. I mean, Zemie, we got more elims in the zero build match than we did in the build match. We were seeing the enemies, we were hitting our shots.
I was
honestly like super impressed with that.
Now, before we go too far, I did want to mention a couple other things about the monitor. One thing that's actually super nice is the interface and the stuff that they've changed with the OLED monitor to make it better. Number one, go and move it up and down, rotate it. Tell me what you think.
Oh, wow.
Just moves up and down, and you've got full rotation. So you can go all the way. Maybe you just want to read some Discord in high OLED, or
that's actually
It's smooth.
That's so easy.
Tell me if this has happened to you before. Like you're trying to find the right button or whatever it was to change whatever it was. Just stick your hand underneath the monitor real quick.
Oh, it just pops up.
And then it just pops up, so it tells you what all the buttons do.
You don't have to press it.
Cool. I can't tell you how many times I've had to like stand up on my desk to try and move my monitor and make sure it's actually at the right hand, trying to position.
You do it just with one hand too.
Literally push it up. Yeah. So.
Test number two, does high refresh rate actually matter? Okay, first up, 60Hz monitor. Now we're using Aim Labs. The ball's gonna show up on screen, you click. You don't have to aim at the ball, nothing like that, very, very simple. It's just about measuring your response time. And we care about the lower the millisecond response time, the better. So much concentration right now. They're so quiet. Zemie, what was your response time?
193.
Okay, Tocata. First round, what was your response time?
189.
Dang.
Okay,
this is 60Hz.
This is 60Hz. That's not bad for 60Hz. It's not bad. Don't get nervous, Emmy.
Do you improve too?
We improved.
Oh my gosh. Okay, Tocata, what was your score this time?
Why is he asking me first? 167.
And then what was yours?
Can we replay that right
now? I did improve to 181.
Now we have the 240 hertz non-OLED high refresh rate monitor. Current leader, Tocata, Zemie.
I mean, I didn't really improve much.
I don't know about that one.
151.
151, so Zemie, where are you at?
182, I got 170.
170, so a pretty massive improvement now from the other ones. And then Tocata, what did you end with?
143.
Okay, guys, Corsair Xeneon 27-inch OLED, last monitor. Tocata still in the lead. Zemie, what was yours on this one?
175.
175. And then Tocata, what was yours?
154.
154. Okay, Zemie, what was your last one?
156.
156. Getting close, but no cigar. And then what was your last one, Tocata?
169.
169. So you guys have tested with all three monitors. You finished with high refresh rate. Now we're gonna drop down back to 60 hertz and see if there's any change in your score. Your lowest score, Zemie, with 60 hertz was 181, and Tocata, yours was 167, which, by the way, congratulations, Tocata, you are the winner. For the 240 hertz, we saw it drop all the way down for you, Zemie, to 156, and then for you, Tocata, 143. So, I guess looking at just the data in general, were you guys surprised at the 60 hertz versus 240 hertz?
Not necessarily. I think we both knew going into it that 60 hertz and 240 hertz are a massive difference. And performance-wise, I think the numbers showed that.
Yeah, yep. I mean, 100%. Zemie even said it in the first game of the match. He got into the game and instantly said, you know, I'm at 60 hertz. This is not 240 hertz. You can tell instantly.
Yeah.
The other thing, too, is that when we looked between the 240 hertz and 240 hertz with OLEDs, your numbers were very much the same. In fact, actually, Zemie, yours improved.
Going into it, I didn't really expect to see too much of a difference because they're both 240 hertz. But I think for the OLED, it's way more, you know, bright and vibrant. But actually, looking at the numbers, I did do my best on the OLED.
Then we jumped back to 60, which, I mean, I know that had to mess with your eyes, but Tocata, what was that experience like? And were you surprised at how much it jumped back, even after playing 10 rounds?
Look, it was bad, okay? But I knew it was gonna be bad, right? Coming from both 240 hertz, going back to 60, it's just not the same world.
So here's the deal. You guys have now, you've had your warm-up games, you've now also basically done your testing, showing that you can have high refresh rate, plus beautiful game. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the stakes at like level 11. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a stream, live stream, so live, your live audience. We're going to play some Fortnite, but you're adding me, who is terrible at Fortnite. And we're adding really bad food.
Oh.
Like clam juice.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I know. And like mackerels with tomato sauce.
Oh,
here's the deal. If I die or we don't get top three, we're eating bad food. But if I see victory royales or like top threes, we're giving away Corsair gear to our communities.
Oh, okay. So just win. Don't,
we just gotta
don't
win.
Lose.
Just get the VR.
We
it's
got
easy
this.
As that.
We got, this.
We got two already. We gotta keep
you
going.
You can hop in the backpack.
I've never won.
I'm ready.
I'm down.
Let's do it.
See that bush right there, Roby? You're
staying
gonna stay
in there
the whole game.
Wait, I'm good.
I don't know how to say this, but Roby's driving right now.
Oh, I'm driving to get out. Good. No, that's not a good idea at all.
Dead? All right, how you doing, Roby? You feeling good?
I'm doing okay. I'm doing okay.
Got one.
One shot on
last
me.
One. Last one.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I just crashed. I just crashed. I don't think that counts as a fail there. Where am I? Oh, I'm in a bunker.
Careful, be careful, Roby.
No!
No!
One, two, three. So we're dropping purple.
Respect, respect.
Yeah. Oh okay, we're good. We're good. No big. Oh shoot!
I'm tanking. Oh my God.
Oh no!
You know what?
No. Oh God!
Don't chug it.
Don't chug it.
Hunter gifted.
Oh, he's leaving. See, he's scared. Yeah.
Roby, come here to the tree.
I'm coming.
To the right.
Oh my gosh.
Man.
Okay, so I'll take it. I'll take the first bite.
The only thing that moved was literally the anchovy.
Whoa.
We got people with us.
Oh, we do.
But
we
got, like, yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, careful, Roby.
I see him, he's crouched. What a good eye. That's that OLED monitor, Roby.
Yeah, it is.
I'm going around.
Crack.
Nice.
You gotta get there quick.
Let's
nice,
go.
Nice, bro. Good job. That is how it's done.
That's a perfect way to, you know,
that is.
End it on.
How many did we get?
Six wins.
Yeah.
Great job. question that we had when we came here was, Corsair asked, is like, can you take a monitor that has the high refresh rate and then marry that with something like an OLED that has the beauty that you're used to? Because sometimes you have to have two monitors, but now they put it together. You guys have spent enough time. The question is, did Corsair do it?
Look, they 100% did. I was kind of skeptical going into this because I've always been using non-OLED monitors that have been, you know, fast, 240 hertz, 1 millisecond response time. And I saw, you know, they claim 0.03 millisecond response time, 240 hertz, but also OLED. And I was like, okay, it might not feel as good, but it actually felt quicker than the monitor I have at home, and it looked better.
I agree. Going into it, you know, I've always thought kind of OLED was just for casual gaming. You can't really get too competitive with it, but, you know, hearing the specs, like you said, the 0.03 millisecond response time, 240 hertz, and then actually looking at it and testing it out, I think they did a great job.
I think one of the things that we do, I want to talk a little bit about that 0.03 millisecond response time. Both of yours are 1 millisecond. And I think both of you have now spent time with something that's faster than, because of the OLED technology, you can now have in a high performance monitor like this. Did you feel that difference even from your other monitor, right, Zemie?
I think that was like one of the first things, other than, you know, how vibrant it was. When I played my first game, I was like, why do I see better, as if it's like more refresh rate, but it's not. So I was assuming it's the response time. And yeah, it definitely is something you notice.
Yeah. Okay. In all high movement situations, it was still super clear, super smooth, and I think that's why it felt like quicker than usual as well.
For the most part, when you go to esports competitions, there's two kind of monitors that are always there. So if you walked in and you saw Corsair had sponsored Worlds or whatever, you know what I mean, and this monitor was on your desk with this, you know, with a system next to it, would you balk at that at all?
Look, I would be. Now knowing how the monitor works, I'm obviously gonna be happy,
right.
But I think a lot of people would be surprised as well when they see how visually appealing it is, but also how quick it is. I think it would be a surprise for a lot of people that haven't used it yet.
Yeah, and I'm assuming the same for you, Zemie?
Honestly, really the same, yeah.
The last and most important question, would you use this monitor? If you had to use this one, would you have any issues whatsoever?
100%.
I mean, if you asked me this before we did all the tests and everything, I would be a little skeptical, just mainly, as I've said this before, it's the size, because I'm used to 24 inch. But now that I've had, like I said, over 10 hours on it, definitely.
So if you could main monitor this, you would main monitor this?
Yeah, I mean, it's like a perfect balance between having a good looking image, but also being fast enough to play competitive, so it's perfect.
Okay, so here's the deal, guys. We are going to give you that monitor. I don't know if you knew that, but we are going to be giving you that monitor. But the other thing is I called AMD and I was like, guys, they're complaining about the performance of their systems and they don't feel like their systems are actually
up to snuff.
So on top of giving you the monitors, we're also going to give you the customized systems as well.
Are you serious? Wait, actually?
Yeah. So not only are you guys going to get the monitors, but you're also going to get to keep the systems.
No.
Big shout out. Obviously, AMD stepped in. They knew that you guys had. They saw how much you actually really like the systems.
I actually didn't expect that. You know, I was like, okay, we'll get the monitor and then... You started talking about AMD. We were talking about how our PCs at home were not really running Fortnite too well. We were using it to code. It's like, nah, it's gotta be the game. We get on these PCs, 1,000 FPS in creative,
like
600 FPS in game on Epic settings. It was actually like a completely different experience.
No, 100%. I mean, thank you guys. Thank you to you. Thank you to Corsair, AMD, everyone. I mean, I said this before, to be able to get the most out of a monitor like that, you need a beast of a PC. And this is the definition of that.
Well, that's it for us. Huge shout out to Corsair, AMD, and LG Displays for sponsoring this video. And for Zemie and Tocata flying out here to beautiful Miami, Florida, and the Rock Esports Center, who let us use their epic facility for this video shoot. If you want more information on the Corsair Xeneon 27-inch OLED monitor, then check down in the description below. Or if you're looking for a system that can power a high refresh rate monitor like that, then check out the AMD Advantage systems. No guesswork, and we have more information on those down below as well. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.